Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the bullpen. I really don't know why I keep inviting him back. He's a dear friend of mine, my brother from another mother, and yes, a conservative, Shelley Wynter, who decided to join me last time, talked about my suit and my shoulders and other stuff. Shelley hosts 95.5 WSB, one of the more listened to stations in the country. How are you, sir?
I'm wonderful, Doc, but that's because you made fun of my checkered shirt, by the way, that my wife Christmas. So that's why I had to defend my wife's Christmas.
I get it, brother. It's all love, man. So today we're going to talk about, and I've been wanting to have this conversation because I think the Colin Kaepernick saga has become lost in our narrative of social justice movement, Black Lives Matter. But we also got to talk about BLM because it has been a significant force, not only in our local city jurisdictions, but also how we converse about social justice. So let me first start with Colin Kaepernick. Was he wrong, brother, for what he did?
No, I've always maintained, even as a conservative, I've always maintained I didn't necessarily agree with the kneeling. My position on the kneeling from Colin Kaepernick from day one was it was the wrong PR move in order to accomplish what he was trying to accomplish. That's always been my position, brother, in that I always felt that targeting the national anthem was not a way to draw attention to that which you wanted to draw attention to, because you welcomed the anger coming at you from the very people that you wanted to bring to your side. But I've always maintained on all my shows that the kneeling didn't bother me. I didn't stop watching football because of it. I wasn't a hater, nothing like that. I always felt from a PR move, it was an opportunity. You allowed the people that you were trying to convince of an issue that was going on in the community, you allowed the opposition to come in because of that which you went after, which was the national anthem.
Let me tell you why I disagree. Let me tell you why I disagree with you. I think it was a great move outside of the realm of PR. Now, you can look at this and say it was a very bad move for his personal public relations status. But look at what was accomplished because of him kneeling. Brother, allow me to finish. Because of his kneeling, the NFL, who fired him de facto, okay, the NFL donated millions and millions and millions of dollars to social justice movements and nonprofit organizations. They then recruited Jay-Z. All right, I can debate all day about how effective Jay-Z has been, but they literally started to recruit black talent in order to become catalysts for social justice movement and money to move towards certain arenas in Chicago, Detroit, New York primarily. So it was because of that protest, and then the NFL on opening day, remember, brother, they played the black national anthem and then the regular version for the rest of the country, I guess, which was really silly to me because the, you know, lift every voice and sing is like a black freedom song, right? So they said, sing this black freedom song, sing this Negro freedom song, but let's still deny Negroes freedom. It was really ridiculous to me how that kind of worked out. Colin Kaepernick has been justified, still never received his employment back in the NFL. But I want you to look at it from this point of view, brother, because you have to admit that there were so many people on the right, especially led by Donald Trump. When Trump made this about the military, Trump made this about the flag, Trump made this about America. And it wasn't about that, it was about being true or being authentic to what you say you are. And I think that's a good notion. This was not about kneeling. Let me put in your mind this. If Colin Kaepernick would have been kneeling to bring more attention, more awareness to the lack of funding for cancer research, he would have never been blacklisted by the NFL. If he would have taken a knee after making a If he would have taken a knee after making a touchdown, which by the way is routine for many who are considered themselves Christians who score a touchdown. They think somehow Jesus has something to do with that. And so they'll take a knee and they'll pray. And nobody had an issue with them taking a knee, even though technically it has always been against the rules, just not enforced, right? So, brother, you gotta see the irony here that a man who took a knee, the most peaceful protest you can engage in, being vilified primarily by those who are connected to your political side. And what do you say to them on the right who tried to make Colin Kaepernick a villain in the story of the movement?
Dude, first of all, sir, we're on a great platform. You have a great show. Very intelligent people watch. You must have just said about 5 different things, all contradicting each other one by one.
And I'm amazed. Tell me which one.
Well, let me finish. Like you said, first of all, you started with how he's the one that created the basically the tagline of the NFL now is Black Lives Matter.
No, he didn't create that. I did not basically say that. Roundabout say that. I don't believe that. I know that he led the NFL because of what he did. The NFL has now given a record amount of money. Yes, it is true.
Because the fact of a man got kneeled on for 8 minutes by a police officer and universally was panned and criticized and hated by both conservatives and left about the murder of George Floyd. That's what changed the NFL's new social justice program.
That's untrue. Let me show you where. Hold on, brother. Brother. I still have to moderate the discussion, brother. So right, let me go ahead.
Like Roger Goodell saying you should have listened to Colin Kaepernick. That's not what I'm saying, man.
Come on, Shelley. The decision.
You want me to talk?
Shelley? You just said something that's a flat out lie. And I care about the audience enough to correct
you. It's not a lie.
Don't be scared to allow my correction.
Now you're gonna call me to be scared? No, man, you ain't gonna do this. You asked my opinion on something.
Shelley, that's not an opinion, brother. You just stated a fact that's incorrect. You have represented a fact that's not real.
Man, come on, dude.
All right, Shelley, you ready?
When you tell me consistently, let me talk.
Shelley, I'm gonna go ahead and correct it, brother. I'm gonna correct what you said. And I'm gonna do it now, then I will allow you to finish. When Shelley said that this only started after the murder of our dear brother George Floyd.
The money came after, Rashad. The money you refer to as to the NFL giving millions of dollars to black causes and Black Lives Matter came after George Floyd. We argued for 2.5 years over Colin Kaepernick. The money came after George Floyd. That's the point I was trying to make. That is incorrect. You can't say he didn't get his flowers or he didn't.
I'm going to ask you, brother, to allow me at least 30 seconds to respond to what you said, brother.
You just spoke for 3 minutes. I can't address what you spoke on for 3 minutes.
I'm going to respond. I'm going to take this opportunity as the host of the show and respond. You see, Shelley, if I was on your 95.5 FM WSB conservative talk station, brother. And you said you needed to make a rebuttal. I would give you the respect due because I know how to be a guest in another person's home. And that would be your home where I'm a guest, brother.
But so you didn't give me time.
I'm going to give you ample time.
You cut me off to correct me on my opinion. That's how you started.
It's not an opinion, Shelley.
Come on, man. We're in a barbershop. You want a suit, a tie? And you asked me a question. I went to answer your question. I started by saying one thing and you jumped in and told me I have to correct it.
We have debated for like 5 minutes on just me correcting you on one point. And you won't give 30 seconds for that.
His opinion in the middle of his answer. You can't correct a man's opinion.
Sir, it's not an opinion when you're giving out things and representing them as fact. So let me go ahead and correct it, all right? The NFL, they started to engage nonprofit organizations and also big money donors.
All right, sir, I'm going to finish. You're telling me Colin Kaepernick caused the NFL to engage nonprofits? They've always engaged nonprofits.
Sir, the point that I'm making.
teaching nonprofit coaches in little leagues for 30 years. What the hell are you
talking
about?
You need to shut the hell up, Shelley. Seriously. Nah, because if somebody, think about this, brother. If somebody was on your show, right? And they kept talking over the host, what would you do? The only reason why I haven't cut this interview, because you're my friend. You really need to get the hell up off the show if you don't respect the fact that I can just pause one moment, make one point, and allow you to finish. Right? It's simple, it's easy. Okay? The record contributions in modern era NFL literally happened 1 year after the Colin Kaepernick incident. Now, they broke the record after that and broke the record again after that. But the increase of funding to social justice movements and nonprofit organizations and also educational programs broke the record after Colin Kaepernick took a knee. 1 year after Colin Kaepernick took a knee. And this was before George Floyd. It was before the murder of our dear brother. After the murder of our brother, it then increased more to another record level. And even with that increase, it was still 0.00164% of the actual budget of the NFL. It wasn't even 1% when it broke the record the last time. So those are your numbers, brother. Go ahead.
So now, what was your point before about your original statement is, we got to applaud Colin Kaepernick for being right on the issue of kneeling and how kneeling helped move this bar forward to the point I was making, how the NFL basically has co-branded and has a marketing partner called Black Lives Matter, which you cannot deny based on the arguments you just made. So how did he lose in this battle? How did we as black people lose in this battle based on what you just said? Because the percentages are too low? I would make the argument that you just made my argument, that the fact is we won. You have the championship trophy. You won the social justice battle with the NFL. You want to call Colin Kaepernick the hero of that battle? Fine. He's gotten his due. He got his deal with Nike. He's gotten his money. So where are we having this discussion at? Where is the argument that we're having right now?
Let me ask you the questions.
Let me finish, my brother. If the argument is
that I should— Let me ask you the questions, brother. You done spewed about four of them already.
Let me first finish my point. I'm not done with my point.
You got questions, brother?
So you cut me off.
I thought you wanted answers to the questions. Okay, you just want to create commentary. Okay, go ahead.
I know nobody would ever go to your house for Thanksgiving because you're a bad host, because you probably serve cheap beer. Can you treat me? Listen.
You're such a damn diva, man. You really are such a diva, brother. I love you to life, brother. But you be on that bull-ish, man. And you know you do. You really are.
Question, brother. I'm answering
your question. Just let me know if you got a question for me. I'll wait till you finish, brother. I got time.
Remember what you said. I'm the guest in your house. I'm answering your question. Your last question to me was, what do you say to those conservatives? Because apparently it was only conservatives that didn't like it.
Right. Primarily.
Well, that's what you said. So I would answer the same way I've always said it. The whole thing I've always maintained was that you could hate them, you could turn off football, you could do whatever you want. You have that right, because those same people are now the ones saying don't cancel people. So as you go out here and tell me what conservatives do, they're doing it. Some of them tuned out football and never came back. Many of them, because the NFL have record ratings right now, are watching. Remember, there was a boycott on both sides of this issue. There was a boycott by black people who liked Colin Kaepernick and felt he was being wrong. And there was a boycott by white conservatives.
And Shelley, I don't mean to interrupt, brother. I do have limited time on the show. We have another show that comes on right after us.
Yelling, and then I'll just sit here and take it. That's a good thing.
Brother, you have actually spoken more than me during this segment. But I will show you the video, and we'll do what's called a time track so you can see how much time you spoke, how much time I spoke. The issue with Colin Kaepernick, you cannot dismiss the reality that when Colin Kaepernick, a peaceful protest of Colin Kaepernick, caused the insane response from people like Candace Owens and even Donald Trump, the president of the United States. Hold on, brother, allow me to finish. Because when they made the connection, a connection you don't even make, that Colin Kaepernick is disrespecting the United States military. Well, the truth is, brother, the United States military their actual mode, their operation is to protect a freedom. The freedom to stand for the anthem and the freedom, brother. Donald Trump said he's disrespecting the US military. That's what Donald Trump said. You can't say nobody has said that. Trump himself said that.
Everything about the national anthem is tied up into the flag, into patriotism, into the military. Those three things go together.
So Trump was right?
Excuse me?
Was Trump right when he said Colin Kaepernick is disrespecting the US military?
I think he was right when he said, I think in his mind, under his opinion, he was right when he said he was disrespecting the US flag.
Was he right to you? In your mind, your opinion, brother, you think for yourself?
Come on, man, don't play this silly corn game.
Wait a minute. You think he was wrong, right? You can't say it, can you, brother? Was Trump right or wrong?
No, is what right or wrong?
Was Trump wrong for saying Colin Kaepernick is waging a social?
He said a lot of things. He said he shouldn't kneel. He said he was disrespecting the military. He said it was disrespecting the flag.
Was Trump right or wrong, brother?
He was disrespecting the national anthem.
Was Trump right or wrong, brother?
Was he right? He was right to say it. Of course he was right to say it.
He was right.
Do I agree with that? See, here's the point that you don't ever get. Do I agree with him? No. Was he right to say it? Yes. So here's what I'm trying to make. Yes.
You're speaking out of both sides of your ass, brother. And you know it. I mean, every day you're getting more and more like a politician, Shelley.
Kneeling is a universal sign unless you're praying, all right? He was taking a knee to protest something. Am I right or wrong?
Yeah, correct. That's right, brother. I'm glad you understand that.
Right. If you're protesting something and it's the flag waving while the national anthem is playing, then you're protesting the flag and the national anthem. Are you not? Yes or no?
Are you anti-military for taking a knee during the anthem, brother?
Do you beat your wife with one or your right or left hand? I mean, he's a silly question.
That's silly. Come on.
Right, exactly. Don't ask me, am I anti-military? Because you know I'm not.
I did not ask if you're anti-military, brother. If you would listen to the questions, you would hear how they oppose to you. Is Colin Kaepernick or was Colin Kaepernick during that saga anti-military?
I have no idea what Colin Kaepernick stands for on anything. He's never told me.
Okay, man. All right, brother.
Has he ever said he was anti-military or not? I don't know. I can't
answer
that
question. Was the protest anti-military? Come on, Shelley.
Can I answer the question? Yeah. I will tell you, I'm almost positive that Colin Kaepernick probably feels the same way about the military that most Americans do. He loves the military. But to protest a flag while singing the national anthem, which he said he was doing, does make him anti-flag and anti-national anthem. And it is fair to say an extension of that is that you don't like the country. I mean, it's a fair.
So let me respond. We got a couple of minutes, brother. One of the things that I think got lost in this conversation and narrative, especially when it hit this national context, is the fact that Colin Kaepernick took a knee to bring attention to a particular thing. And what he wanted to bring attention to was the insane violence against black and brown bodies as it relates to policing in the United States of America. That is what he wanted to bring attention to. This was before George Floyd. This was before Breonna Taylor. This was before all of those instances. He said, we as a nation must pay attention to this because it's happening right under our nose and it is injustice in fact. That's what he took the knee for. But let me show you how slick the NFL is. The NFL, they finally come around. Let me finish, brother. Let me show you how slick. Brother, I'm going to finish my point, brother, with or without you, brother. You can stay here or go. The NFL is so slick. What they ended up doing to co-opt the social justice movement, they brought in Jay-Z. They tell Jay-Z to tell folks, this is not about kneeling anymore, we move beyond kneeling. Now I want you to remember, this was about bringing awareness to unarmed black and brown folks being killed by police, right? That's what the kneel was about. They come in, the NFL comes in, they co-opt Jay-Z, they co-opt this person, co-opt that person. And what do? They do concerts and they raise money to contribute to educational programs in Chicago, Detroit, and other places. Now, educational programs are great. I have no issue with educational program, but that's not what Colin Kaepernick took a knee for. He took a knee for the social justice issue of unarmed black people being killed by the police, something the NFL did not address. They did a pivot. They said these are safe nonprofit organizations that do not deal with the social dynamic and the social dilemma of unarmed black people being shot and killed. It was a trick from the beginning, brother. So I'm probably with you on the fact that the NFL co-opted the movement, changed the focus of it, gave a bunch of money to other noteworthy organizations while ignoring the reason Colin Kaepernick took a knee in the first place.
Okay, so let's go back to what you said originally. So Colin Kaepernick should be celebrated or not for moving the NFL to something that the NFL has co-opted and not even focuses on anyway. So Colin Kaepernick's still a hero. Let me understand that's what you said.
Yeah, he's definitely, brother. Let me tell you why. We got 2 minutes. You just took one. I'm gonna respond to that.
Absolutely, brother.
30 seconds, man. 30 seconds.
30 seconds.
Go ahead, respond. I'll respond to you.
Lastly, Colin Kaepernick's protest had to work. Because since Joe Biden got elected, I have not heard about Black Lives Matter, and I have not seen a police shooting pop up in my algorithm, nor has the black left and black Democrats talked about it.
Yeah, that's a lie. Let me tell you what we can show. All right, listen, brother, I gotta respond. I'm running out of show, brother. I have a format here. Shelley, I have a format.
Because we haven't heard since Biden.
Go ahead and cut his microphone. I do need to end the show. Thank you, brother. So here's the reality. We highlight stories that Black Lives Matter. They are continuing to fight unarmed black and brown folk being killed by the police. We are highlighting those stories on Indisputable damn near every single day. So they are still happening. As it relates to Colin Kaepernick, you're damn right you should celebrate him, just like you should celebrate Muhammad Ali, who took a stance against the Vietnam War, even though he did not stop the Vietnam War. His stance was still heroic. And you should absolutely celebrate men and women who take a stance for what they believe in. All right, I gotta go, brother. It's been fun all the time. Galaxy Brain is next. Remember, be good to yourself.
Peace.
Remember, take care of yourself. He got me discombobulated, all right? Take care of yourself, man. Shut the hell up. You like it, once again, an ex-girlfriend, man. You don't listen, go, bye. What's wrong with you? Why? Shelley.
Now I'm a girl. See how you do me?